I cannot afford to buy proper foods and nourishment for myself, or vitamins, or, you know, any recreation. I never go out. All I do is watch TV. You know, I have no money to go nowhere. The baseboard eaters are not good because they do not give enough eat. The house is still cold as ice. Like, I go in my bedroom and I'm so cold, I gotta put my coat on. And my heater is blast up. I cut off my eating in March, the second week of March. And you know, April and May was very cold. I freeze in here. And my bill was still $380.
The age of our buildings is such that they're not necessarily the most energy efficient. And what we're finding is where the tenants pay the utility costs, they're paying perhaps a disproportionate part of their income on such things, where, you know, food and lodgings is taking up a large part. And I think that sometimes the costs are greater because it's electricity and it's baseboard heating.
Hydro Ottawa acts as a kind of independent city-owned entity. So what it means is that the total amount that it earns from the rates that it charges is minus the amount that it pays out in terms of staff and also to buy the electricity from the province. Ideally, this money should really be kind of reinvested back into the community. One of the ways would be to use a large portion of this money to fund the low-income program. And this would kind of help upgrade the housing stock and also reduce the amount of energy that Ottawa was using in total.
I think if we had additional funding, we'd be able to more quickly become more energy efficient and track those savings to then reinvest them in our communities.
I see a picture with a mayor and all these people sitting all sitting down, and I just laugh. Because these people are not doing anything for poor people. Poor people suffering, you know? It's not fair.
Ecology Ottawa is asking all election candidates to commit to investing Hydro Ottawa profits back into energy efficiency improvements for low-income households. In 2009, Hydro Ottawa made the City of Ottawa $17.6 million. And so we think that that would go a long way into really improving the lives of people who live in low-income housing and are struggling with high hydro bills.